Well, everybody, it's Jonathan, a.k.a. Senor Smoke from the Ring of Fire in Westchester County, New York. I bid you welcome. Today, we have another outdoor kitchen analysis. This island recently finished, a few months ago, is in Briarcliff Manor, New York, in Westchester County, and had a great time working on this project with this homeowner, who was actually a Yonkers native, like myself, so always like to take care of my Yonkers peeps. A fun project, pretty straightforward. Let's talk about it. The island structure is a Ring of Fire outdoor kitchen solution. So we designed it, we rendered it, we built it, we installed it. The reason why he went with our island as opposed to having his mason dude out of block, he came, if I remember correctly, he was running into a time constraint. And also the cost of doing it out of cinder block he felt was a little prohibitive, but I believe it was mostly due to timing. So we were able to turn this island around in probably, I think it was about 3 weeks, maybe a little longer. But in any case, it's a pretty straightforward, it's our most popular style, which is an L. It's 10 feet by 7 feet. On the long side, he's using a 48-inch DCS 7 series grill, and that was the only thing that he wanted on the countertop. He wanted as much counter space as possible. So he's got his 48 DCS. Underneath it, he has a Blaze 39-inch door and draw combo. We'll talk a little bit about that in a second. Don't mind the sirens. He also has the Blaze trash and recycle double bin, if you want to call it that, the BLZTRECDRW. It's a very, very popular piece. He has a Blaze paper towel holder, and on this the grill side, he has a Summit 24-inch refrigerator. So let's try to get our wrap our arms around the whole logic behind this island. He wanted to go high-end on the cooking equipment. High-end but value-driven, that's what the DCS 7 series provides. It's about $1,000 or so lower in price than the 9 series, and isn't that far off. I mean, it's the same burn box, it's the same burners, etc., etc. There's just the 9 series has a few embellishments. He did not think it was worth going in that direction. And then what he wanted to do underneath, he wanted value. I mean, if we had used the DCS components, it would have been significantly more expensive. So what he did, what many of our customers do, I mean, I do this a lot on the alfresco side of things as well. You spend the money on the cooking devices and you save on what's underneath. And that's why he went with Blaze. Again, the Blaze door and draw combo, 39 inches. The only drawback of using that piece with this grill is it's asymmetrical. You have a 48 inch grill, a 39 inch door and draw combo. They don't line up. There are some folks out there, these are probably people who come from the headspace of my dishwasher handle has to match the handle on my stove. I could appreciate that coming from the appliance side of things. This guy didn't care about that. So he went with value. He went with the dual trash and recycle bin from Blaze, the paper towel holder from Blaze. And then even on the refrigerator, instead of getting, I mean, the DCS refrigerator is $2,500, okay? So that's out of the question. He didn't even opt to go with the Blaze fridge, which is 13-ish, okay? He went with a Summit. I believe it was the SPR 627OS, which is sub $1,000. So definitely a value-driven, high-end island. What else to talk about? He used a granite countertop, and he used real stone. Real stone, but a stone veneer, very similar that you would see like the Brookfield product out of Connecticut. It's real stone, but it's cut like in half. So it's much easier to adhere to an island, whether it's out of cinder block or it's out of like what we do here at Ring of Fire. So it's a beautiful island. I mean, you could see some of the pictures here of us delivering the products, dry fitting them, and then the end result is just absolutely fantastic. But he really, mission accomplished. I mean, he wanted, a value-driven, yet high-end kitchen. He didn't need side burners. He didn't want a pizza oven. He didn't need a Kamado, which I think that's hopefully his next purchase. He just wanted that huge grill. Okay, and the 48-inch DCS is the largest grill without a sear burner that you could buy. And, he didn't want to draw water over to the island. This is close enough to his kitchen to use that. So he really got all the counter space that he wanted. He got his monster grill, and he's got his outdoor fridge, and he's good to go and as happy as a pig in mud. So it was a fun product, a project to work on. And again, the time frame on, they didn't really take too long to turn it around between the rendering was pretty straightforward. We didn't have to do like 5 revisions. He was like, bang, good to go, let's make it happen. And I think that from the time he was in here till delivery, I mean, maybe it was a month, and this was like in the height of things. Okay, so here we have another example of a island that was executed in the midst of the pandemic, and we nailed it and got it done, and he's very happy. Any questions, please hit me up, jonathan@curtos.com, or questions at rofgrills.com. We're happy to help. Many more of these videos coming up, and we hope to see you here at some point, because 2021 is almost here, and there are plenty of folks who are planning their outdoor kitchens as we speak. Thank you.